going back, back to Cali, Cali. I'm going back, back to Cali, Cali, Cali. I'm going back, back to Cali, Cali. I'm going back, back to Cali, Cali.
He lost one of your most instrumental players in former Devon Jostling. Replacing him, how has that been going?
But it's very hard to replace a guy that scored 25 goals in every season. 3 years, 25 goals, 24 goals, 20 goals, and up. You know, it's very difficult to replace him because he was naturally the go-to man at times when the chips down on us. You know, we also lost Carter last year, and we struggled a little bit to win the title without him. He's now back in training and all that. So we're going to try our best to see if we can find another Jocelyn, as you say. It have guys that have the potential, but they didn't step up to the table as yet. But during this season, I feel they will do it.
Well, in Mova Savannah with a guy named Hilton Bailey, that was my first coach. He introduced me. Well, he teach me the basics of the game. I went to Mova North Primary School. From there, I went on to Malik Secondary Comprehensive, where we won the league and the Big Four title. Then I moved on to W Connection. I win basically all the youth titles it had us to win there. Then I had a short stint with Caledonia before joining Defence Force. Playing against Defence Force is difficult for me. I try to be professional about it, but it's difficult. You know, because the guys who make it even more difficult is majority of the guys on Defence Force team is my batch. You know, we train together. You know, we endured the hardship of military training together. So coming up against them is very difficult for me. You know, in Defence Force is a rough place, and if you could cope with the rigors of recruit training, you could cope with anything. You know, when I went across to America, I had difficult times. In the sense that I went across there and they had an extra striker and he had form. So I was on the bench a lot, you know, but I never lose my cool, and I think that's where the Defence Force come in.
Well, playing with Jocelyn is a boost for me because, you know, he encouraged me, he shows me things that, you know, because I'm still at a learning process, and this, he has more experience at the senior level, so he give me, you know, we play the same position, so he guides me along the way, helped me to teach me the art of finishing, because, you know, he's a proven goal scorer, as well as he showed me how to make proper runs and all these little things that will help in my game to improve in the future. Well, there is a fight for position, because on any days, you know, it's friendly competition, and competitive competition is always good for the team, you know. And even in training, we do, when we are doing finishing, me and Justin and myself, we compete. You know, we see who could score the most goals and stuff like that. So it's always good, because in that case, I will be a better player, and he will also become a better player for himself as well. So that's all.
Well, at present, I'm concentrating on Caledonia, but I have some offers in the A-League. It's just working out the best offer for me. But nothing is on papers yet. You know, it have teams interested, but nothing is on papers yet. But at present, it's concentrating on helping Caledonia win the Digicel Pro League.
He don't cry with football when he asks him to come football. He does alone go football on the bus with his friends.
I think me and my daughter have a special relationship. You know, when I was 17 years, she mother made her so. And from ever since, when I go into practice, I carry her when I could carry her. So that's my number one fan. You know, I think she understands the game as a girl, and a 10-year-old, she understands the game. So sometimes when I lost and I sad, she sad. When I win, and happy, she happy. So, like sometimes she be telling me like, "Daddy, Missy, how they see any news?" You know, so she look up to me. So I have to try and set the right example. You know, she wants to play football and all, but I tell her football is not for she. You know, books. But she look up to me. So I have to try and set the right example. Greatest feeling I just get is when I come home from practice and my daughters greet me, or like say I went overseas and come back and your kids greet you. It's not no better feeling than that, being around your daughters. You know, sometimes football is an emotional game, and you know, sometimes I lose a game and it's only she can cheer me up, you know, nothing else, no woman, no. So I think it's a special thing to have a bond with your kids.
From small, I saw his potential. And one thing he always tell me, he said, "Daddy, first thing he tell me that I cannot forget at all is like, he say, 'Daddy, I'm strong enough. I lift up a whole gas tank, eh? I'm a full tank.' I say, yeah." He say, and the next thing he tell me I wouldn't forget is, he said, 'Daddy, I could well play football, boys. I will make you happy, I'll make you proud.' And you know, see, these two things I always remember it and think. And somebody from small, almost every game he play, you know, they're winning. Any side he play on, he usually win, you know. So I enjoy the pleasure of just, you know, watching him play, support him, give him advice, you know, try to keep him cool, calm, composed. And this one thing I know for sure, he might be fast, but see, football sense, he have a lot of football sense. Thank God for that. There are a few of players that I know have that amount of football sense. And, you know, just make me proud, you know. It's just maybe a bit unlucky to make certain teams and things, but to me, he's one of my heroes in football, you know, something like that.
Well, I have four sisters. I'm the oldest boy. But my mom was a single parent. My dad, how should I put it? To be honest, he never support me financially, I could say. But every game, you will see him supporting. And I appreciate that. You know, the person who really support me financially in my career was my granddad. You know, but my father, he's up to this day, any pro league game anyway, see I'm playing football, you'll see him. You know, my mom, she did the best she can because she was a single parent, but I must say my father support me. Although he didn't support me financially, he was always there. You know, anywhere I go, anyway, if I go to play, you know, sometimes when I was in defense force, we go into Tobago, he want to come to Tobago, you know, so I thank him for that. And that's something I think we're really lacking, you know, in these kind of communities. You know, sometimes your child tell you they want to run. And you, as a parent, you never really go and see your son or your daughter run. You know, and I thank my father for encouraging me. You know, he encouraged me. If it's this you want to do, I may not have the money to support you financially, but he always there supporting me. Well, my mom, my mom very strict, you know. Sometimes she come home from work and I go in Savannah and I come home, I'll get licks. But she always support me. She did the best she can. You know, I can't fault her. But you know how women tend to be, she was tending to lean on the book side, study work in school and stuff like that. But it's football. So, but she does come, when she get the opportunity to come, she does come and watch and support. No, I think it's something I have to do because I've been blessed with the opportunity to play with guys like Dwight York and Dennis Lawrence and those type of guys now with that kind of experience. And you know, one thing I always used to watch how they conduct themselves, you know? And for me now, I feel it's my time, you know, to be a mentor to the younger guys, you know, to tutor them in that way. My immediate goal is to get back outside as soon as possible. You know, I think I get a good experience of playing outside. I know what it takes, you know, so I just hope the opportunity arise again and I could go back outside and have a successful career outside, you know, and probably come back home and influence people in these kind of areas, you know. If I could do it, you know, that might influence one or two guys that they could do, it could be done.